Hello students, you know all that we have started our chapter, that is magnetic effect of current. Clear? Chapter name is what? Magnetic effect of current. We will divide this chapter mainly in three parts. Number one, we will discuss electrical behavior. In the case of electrical behavior, I told you different points like that. By electric current we can produce magnetic field or magnetic field lines, okay, and we can include different application in it, like that electromagnet. Second part I will discuss in it, that is the working means I will give some external magnetic field, okay, by giving some external magnetic field, and I will put any conductor which are connected with electric current, okay. Simply I can include, we have, this is magnetic field, okay, just I am keeping here one conductor in between both magnet, this is north pole, this is south pole. In between this given magnetic poles, we can say that this is our north pole, this is our south pole, okay. And when we will connect this conductor with electricity, what will we see here, that so simply this conductor start rotating in this given magnetic field. So we can say there, by this rotation we can complete here any work. Simply we can connect this rotating things with any another, and we can easily rotate to other things also by the help of it. We can include like that DC motor, okay, it's means examples. And second thing, we can include here AC motor. Third thing, we can include, simply we will give magnetic field. Third is rotation, and by the influence of both we can produce electric current, okay or not, okay. So simple thing, first I discussed with you all student, we have finished our this portion, means electrical portion, means by electrical portion we can means produce magnetic field, okay, or simple application of it, that electromagnet, many things. So simple I'm telling again, by the help of electric current we can produce magnetic field, or application comes, that is the electromagnet. What? Electromagnet. Or by the help of this electromagnet we can pick means so much heavy things, and we can take means things from one place to another place easily. Clear? And second thing we can include in it, that working. In the case of working, or in the case of production of electric current, we will take three things. Number one, magnetic field. Number two, we can take, first we can take magnetic field, second electric current, or number three, force. Okay or not, okay. If magnetic field is given and electric current is given, then we will get force. Force means what? Rotation. Basic outline I am giving here. Second thing, if we can say magnetic field is given, it can be natural magnet you can include in it. If magnetic field is given and force means what? Rotation is given, then you can produce electric current easily. Clear? So both are completing to each other. We can say magnetic field is mandatory in both cases. If you are giving electric current, so simply, or magnetic field, so by the help of it you can produce rotation in anything. Simply this is natural magnet. Clear? This is what? Natural magnet. This is the north pole, south pole. In between you will keep any conductor, it can be soft iron, anything else, or when you will connect with electricity. So when you will give electric current in it, and simply when you will give a magnetic field in this given a soft iron, so this soft iron start rotating in given magnetic field. Okay students, so in that case you can include, if magnetic field is given, second इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इज गिवेन, तो बाय द हेल्प ऑफ इट वी कैन प्रोड्यूस फोर्स. फोर्स मीन्स व्हाट? रोटेशन इजीली. और बेस्ट एग्जांपल ऑफ इट दैट डीसी मोटर. इन द केस ऑफ डीसी मोटर यू कैन सी देयर वी विल कनेक्ट डीसी मोटर विद इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बाय द वायर्स. ओके, एंड वी कैन इंक्लूड when you will open the DC motor, so inside you can see natural magnet are present. Smallest, in the case of smallest motor, that is the one kind of toy you can see in that time, in that case. Clear? On in that case, simply you can see when you will open the motor, inside you can see, you can feel the effect of magnet. So we can say we are giving magnetic field, and when you will connect this with the given cell, means with electric current, so on that time you can see their rotation, you will see in the case of DC motor. So simply we can include with both things, magnetic field and electric current, that is the rotation influence. Okay or not? Okay. Third thing in this case we can include, listen. If magnetic field is mandatory, right? If magnetic field is given and rotation is given, rotation means force is given. So if force is given, by the help of both things, we can produce what? Electric current easily. By the help of both, we can produce electric current easily. So these are the simple condition which are helping for understanding the concept of means the production of the electric current. Means in the previous case, by the help of electric current we can produce magnetic field, but here by the help of magnetic field we can produce electric current, we can produce rotation. Both things we can produce. So we can say both are inversely proportional, means opposite to each other. Electric current responsible for production of the magnetic field, or magnetic field is responsible for production of the electric current. Okay, so in this case we can include electrical generator. In the case of electric generator, what will you do? You will give there what? Magnetic field, and second you will give there rotation, means you will rotate a generator by the help of anything like that, any tractor engine, any means device you can take for making this generator into the rotation. So by the rotation you can produce what? Electric current easily. So this is the example of generator. All these things I will discuss when we will move forward. All these things I will discuss. Before explaining these topics, I am including here two points. Number one, Fleming left hand rule. Second, Fleming right hand rule. Okay or not? Okay. In the case of right hand, what will you do? You will take your right hand. In this case, what will you do? You will take your all three things, your thumb, first finger, this is your second finger. You will keep them at same like it. Simply it looks like that, means all three are perpendicular to each other. Okay, students, all three are perpendicular to each other, we can say at 90 degree angle. Okay, you can see your thumb, you can see your this finger, you can see your this mid finger. So we can say all these three things should be at 90 degree. Okay or not? Okay. So in that case, what will we do? Your thumb, show their motion. Motion means rotation direction. Okay or not? Okay. Rotation direction. Second thing, your this second finger showing their magnetic field. Okay, and we can say your third things showing their electric current. I'm showing the proper diagram of it. Okay, just wait for 1 minute. In the diagram you can see this is your hand. Okay, in both it can be left hand, it can be right hand, but application will be different in both cases. But simply first you should understand the things there properly. Listen one thing, in this case we can use your left hand, we can use your right hand. Okay, so simply left hand is given here. So in the case of left hand, this is your this finger. Okay, and this is your second, this one finger. Okay, this is your thumb. Clear? So we can say your thumb is showing here motion direction. Motion means force direction. and this finger is showing here what? Magnetic field direction. And third, this finger is showing here current direction. What? Current direction. So simply you have to keep all three things, thumb, both fingers at 90 degree angle. When you will keep all these three things at 90 degree angle, so you can say your thumb is showing their motion direction. Here is not a more understanding. This is a simple concept only. You will include your thumb, this finger and this finger. So in this case, thumb will show here the direction of force and this finger will show their magnetic field direction and this finger will show their current direction. So we can say these are the simple things we can include. We can include in this case right hand thumb rule and the left hand thumb rule. Right hand thumb rule and the Fleming left hand thumb rule. Okay, student. So this is the basic concept for understanding the right hand, means Fleming rules. Okay, by making simple understanding here. See, concept we can make. Listen, this is for thumb. This is your first finger. This is your central finger. Okay, take first word in each case. This is central finger. Central finger means C. C means current. C means current, okay. This is your first finger. First means F. F means field. Field means magnetic field. Okay. This is your thumb. Thumb means T. T means thrust. Or thrust is one kind of force. Or force means motion. Or motion means rotation. Okay. So we can say this is the simple understanding. In this case, if you will include thumb means thrust means force. If magnetic field comes from first finger means F means field, and central finger C you will take, and C means current. So this is the simple explanation in the case of your right hand thumb rule and the left hand thumb rule. If you will ask from you right hand thumb rule, in that case you will include your right hand. If you will ask from you the left hand thumb rule, in that case you will include your left hand only. But working will be different. In the case of DC motor, you will use your left hand, or in the case of generator, you will use your right hand. Okay, I told you that we will differentiate between the Fleming rules according to their application. Application means generator and DC motor. These are the application of the magnetic field part. Now I'm discussing with you all the magnetic field part. Okay, this is the basic outline application or and explanation. Clear? So simply, if you will use DC motor, in the case of DC motor, what will you do? You will take your Fleming left hand rule. And in the case of generator can be DC or AC. So simply it's a little bit different to each other. We can say in the case of DC you will get DC output, in the case of AC generator you will get alternating current output. So on that time you will use here your Fleming right hand rule for proper understanding. So these are the basic details about the magnetic fields and the Fleming left hand and right hand rule. Okay, students. First, I will discuss working part. Working part, in this case, we will include three things. Number one, magnetic field. Number two, force means rotation. Right? Or number three, electric current. If working part I am discussing, in that case simply we will give two things. Number one, magnetic field. Number two, electric current. Okay, then we will get what? Rotation means force. Rotation means force we will get. So this is the simple understanding. Listen one thing I'm telling. If you will take magnetic field, electric current, you will get rotation. How? Listen, if you have a magnetic field. Magnetic fields you can get from nature only, natural magnet only. In that case, you can say it can be North Pole, it can be South Pole. Clear? We know that magnetic lines will be from where? North Pole to South Pole. Right? In between, you will keep any material which can be connected with electric current. Okay, not okay with AC mains, DC mains, anything else. What will you see there? When you will switch on the key, what will you see? After keeping the key closed, then electric current start moving through this coil, this conductor. Then, and we are keeping this coil in between the magnetic field. On that time, this iron piece start rotating around its axis. So we can say there we will get the rotation, and if we will get the rotation on that time, we can include only two things. We are giving magnetic field and electric current. After that, we will get a rotation. Deeply, I will discuss DC motor later. But one thing, this rotation means that force which are coming. This force depends on three things. Listen carefully. Number one, this force directly proportional to the magnetic field. If you will take a more strongest, higher value of the magnetic field here at that point and at that point, on that time you can see here in this iron piece will be there more rotation. So we can say we will get more rotation, we will get there more force. So this force directly proportional to the magnetic field. And in the case of second thing, if this force directly proportional to current, if we will increase here current value, on that time you can say there we will get more rotation. Third thing, size of this conductor, this iron piece. If its size is smaller, so you will see there you will get less rotation. If you will increase its size, then you will get there more rotation. This is the simple explanation. Try to understand one thing. Listen, I'm just discussing with you all. You can take example of smallest DC motor which are using for playing games. Okay, in that case, any toy car, when you will use inside it, you will see there one smallest motor can be there. So this motor depends on three things. If you will give there around this inner system around it, if you will increase magnetic field, you will see there more force, more rotation. If you will increase current value into the motor, then motor will show there more rotation. And inside it, you will take its size more small size. If you will take a smaller size, on that time less rotation, and you will take more size, you will get there more rotation. So we can say there this rotation, this force depends on three points. Number one, applied external natural magnetic field. Number two, current value which are you giving here. And third thing, size of the given conductor which are you going to keep inside the given magnetic poles, in between the magnetic poles. So on that time you can say this is the simple explanation regarding to the force production. Okay.